Shuttle system is used when you want to bring goods to an operator and instead of taking your operator to go find the goods. So typically, operators would walk up and down an aisle, pick up products, put them on a cart, run through the whole DC, bring that to the front, and then ship it. A shuttle brings all those goods to the operator in the front already, so he doesn't have to walk through the complete DC. A shuttle system consists of a few different pieces of equipment. One is a shuttle. It runs back and forth on a rail system between racks. Inside of those racks are containers that have products. The shuttle then picks up those containers, brings them to a lift at the end of the aisle. Lift takes it all the way to the first lower level, and then an operator can take goods out of that container. The container then goes back up into the rack. Today, people are using shuttles in a variety of different situations. Piece picking or each picking, where one product then needs to be shipped to a customer. Use shuttles to bring the products down and then take the leftover products back up. They're using it for case picking, so going from a storage situation back to a palletizing to shipping. Then that ends up being somewhat of a shipping buffer type configuration. That shipping buffer configuration then also leads to like a cross-docking scenario where you can receive, go into the shuttle, reconfigure it to ship to your stores on the other side. Accuracy today is becoming more and more critical because more orders go out the door. So if you had 5% inaccurate orders before and you had 2,000 a day, now you've got 20,000 a day. So accuracy becomes more and more of an issue as the number of orders goes up. When a customer starts to look at shuttles as a potential solution, we want to know the volume of the building, length, width, and height that we have to work in, what kind of SKU list they have, how many SKUs, and how fast they use those SKUs. In other words, how many are coming in, how many are going out in a day. Customers are looking at a lot of different avenues justifying the cost of a shuttle system today. One is quality of picking and how many errors are made and how many errors aren't made when you use a shuttle system. The size of the building and how much storage space a shuttle system can get into the same amount of floor space that traditional storage used to be able to get. Saves a lot of money in the building and cost itself. Shuttles typically are a higher level investment, which leads you to believe you need the highest throughput. But we're using shuttles now in lower throughput, lower use situations, lower storage situations, and the payback is still there. With the labor shortages today, people are finding it tougher and tougher to staff their DCs. Shuttles can eliminate the labor for picking operations and you turn it into a goods to operator instead of an operators to goods. The payload of Intelligrated shuttle is higher than the average of the industry, so we can handle more weight, which allows you to put more stuff into your containers. We also can go deeper into the rack with our load handling device, which allows us to go 1, 2, 3, or 4 containers deep in the rack and still reach at and bring it in for storage. So we increase the amount of storage in the same square footage of building. The reason to go Intelligrated for shuttles is the team that we have here. Dedicated, long tenured team, multiple industries. You bring all of that knowledge and expertise to focus on one solution for the customer, and it's powerful.